All my life I've messed around with art, but I would have to say that I didn't choose art, rather it chose me. I never considered art as a career. I knew deep in my heart that it would not pay the bills. Instead, I became an elementary school teacher. Over the years though, I took art classes and craft classes whenever I got a chance. I took ceramics, I took sculpture, printmaking, jewelry making, I took oil painting, I took watercolor, I even took oil pastels on one occasion. Every chance I got, I messed around with art. But when I retired from teaching and took up soft pastels, I truly fell in love. I began to take those little messy sticks of pure pigment ever and ever more seriously. I searched out and studied with many of the most eminent pastel artists of today. What had begun as a mere retirement diversion became a serious pursuit. I had truly fallen in love with pastels. I've always loved being outside in nature. As a child, the Southern California hills were my playground. I was allowed to roam free in the solitude of the great outdoors. In the evening, I would return home, smelling of sage with stickers in my socks. Weekends and many summer vacations were spent at the beach, body surfing in the ocean, and with the waves and sound of the surf lulling me to sleep at night. Perhaps these early adventures have influenced me because it is California landscapes and seascapes that are my preferred subjects to paint. I love to paint outdoors, plein air. I believe that when I'm outdoors in nature, I absorb the sensory images of the day, and that imagery becomes a part of each painting. The ocean in particular is a muse for me. I paint the rhythms and movements of the sea, and it thrills me to capture the transparency and depths of the water. I spend many hours by the ocean, observing the wave action, and memorizing the sounds, scents, and feelings of each unique day. I often do small studies outdoors, then take photo references to use back in the studio. It is impossible to capture the movement of a wave accurately without the use of a camera. But the lighting and colors I paint outdoors are more correct than what the camera is able to reproduce. Painting outdoors can sometimes be messy and inconvenient though. I've had to put up with a lot of terrible weather. Wind is a particular enemy. It has blown over my easel and pastels on more than one occasion. But when I get back to the studio to paint from my reference photos, even the lousy weather becomes a part of my painting. The scents and sounds, the warmth and chill of the air, the lighting and time of day, all of these things become evident in my painting.